पैकिंग एफिशिएंसी और पैकिंग फ्रैक्शन। नाउ वी ऑल नो स्टूडेंट दैट सॉलिड्स आर मेड अप ऑफ दिस स्फेरिकली साइज्ड पार्टिकल्स कॉल्ड एटम्स एंड दीज एटम्स हैव गॉट सम डेफिनेट वॉल्यूम। सो ऑब्वियसली वी कैन कैलकुलेट द परसेंटेज ऑफ टोटल स्पेस ऑक्यूपाइड बाय the particles in the solid, and this is called as packing efficiency. So packing efficiency is the percentage of total space occupied by the particles inside the solid. Now there is another term used here called packing fraction. So what is packing fraction? The difference is here we are using percentage in packing efficiency and fraction for packing fraction of a solid. The fraction of total space occupied by the particles in the solid is called as packing fraction. Now for working in packing student, let us consider small r to be radii of each sphere and small a to be edge length of the cube. Now packing efficiency is equal to Z. What does Z stand for, student? Z here stands for number of atoms. Z stand for number of atoms. So Z means number of atoms into volume of one sphere. We know that atoms are spherical in size. So volume of one sphere multiplied by the total number of sphere will give us volume of all the spheres present in the unit cell divided by volume of cube multiplied by 100, because we are considering packing efficiency. So we have to calculate percentage here. So packing efficiency will be equal to Z. What is Z? Z is number of atoms into volume of one sphere. This is 4 by 3 pi r cube, and the volume of cube is a cube edge length cube multiplied by 100. And if we are calculating just packing fraction, don't multiply it by 100, it will be your packing fraction. Now we have to work on these three unit cells, and we will calculate the packing efficiency in case of simple cubic, in case of body centered cubic, and in case of face centered cubic. Now let us work on simple cubic system. So very clearly, student, we can see here that in this diagram, from here to here, means from A to B, AB is what? A. AB is A. You can see here, AB is A. This is the edge length of the cube. And we can also see here that this edge length is actually the radii of two sphere. This is the radii of first sphere from here to here, and from here to here radii of second sphere. So we can clearly see here that A is equal to 2r. A is equal to 2r. So obviously for calculating the packing efficiency for the solid, we have to establish a relationship between A and R, then only we can do the calculation. So here what we have got, student, here we have got a relationship between A and R as A is equal to 2R. Very important for solving numerical, students. A is equal to 2R. Now let us work here. Packing efficiency formula is known to us. Packing efficiency is equal to Z. Z means number of atoms. Z for simple cubic is equal to 1. Simple cubic system comprises of only one sphere, only one atom, into 4 by 3 pi r cube divided by a cube. And what is a cube? A cube is 2r cube. So this is 2r cube multiplied by 100. So we can solve it as, this is equal to 4 by 3 pi r cube into 8 r cube. cube multiplied by 100. So let us cancel out r cube from either of from the numerator and denominator. So this comes out, and let us cancel out 4 1 is 4, 4 2 is 8. So this comes out to be pi by 6 multiplied by 100. Student, if we have to calculate packing fraction, the answer would have been pi by 6. But since we are calculating packing efficiency, so we have to multiply it by 100. And the answer here comes out to be, you do the calculation by your own, this comes out to be 52.4%. So the packing efficiency in case of simple cubic system is 52.4%. Now let us do the calculation for BCC, body centered cubic. So this is a corner atom. You can see here, student, you can very clearly see here that this is a corner atom. Corner atom. This is also a corner atom, same. And this is body atom. This we can see that this is body atom. This is body atom. And these two are corner atoms. So this is corner atom. This is corner atom. And this is body atom. This I have represented. Now let us mark it as A. This is B. So this is A and this is B. This is A here and B. We are representing it like this. Now let us do some mathematics, student. Let us consider it as C. So you just check this out and let this be equal to D. This one as D. So student, we can clearly see that in triangle ACD, in triangle ACD, what we can see that this AD is edge length A and CD is also edge length A. So AC will be root 2A. So AC is equal to under root of AD square plus CD square. So this is equal to under root of A square plus A square, which gives us root 2A. This gives us root 2A. And this, let us consider this triangle, triangle ACB. In triangle ACB, what we are having? ACB. Student, this angle is of 90 degree, angle C is of 90 degree. So this BC, this BC is edge length A. So this is A, this is root 2A. So this is your hypotenuse. So here AB is equal to under root of, this is equal to root 2A square. Root 2A square means AC square plus BC square is A square. So this is equal to root 3A. And student, what is AB? What is AB? We can clearly see from here that this is the radii of a sphere. This is 2 radii diameter and this is radii of a sphere. So AB is equal to what? 4R. So we can establish a relationship here that 4R is equal to root 3A. Or we can say that A is equal to 4R by root 3. A is equal to 4R by root 3. This is the relationship between A and R here. Relationship between A and R, A is equal to 4R by root 3. So if we calculate the packing efficiency here, packing efficiency is equal to Z, means number of atoms in case of body centered cubic, Z is 2, multiplied by 4 by 3 pi R cube. And A cube is what, student? A cube is 4R by root 3 cube multiplied by 100. If we do the calculation, student, it comes out to be 68%. So this is the packing efficiency in case of BCC, body centered cubic. Now let us work on the third one, which is face centered cubic. So this is, let it be A, let it be B, this is C. Students, we can see here very clearly that this AC's edge length A and BC is also edge length A. So AB is what? Root 2A. AB is root 2A here. So we can write it as in triangle ABC. In triangle ABC, we have to calculate this AB. This angle is of 90 degree. So AB is equal to under root of, this is A square and this is also A square. So A square plus A square is equal to root 2 A. This is AB. And AB is also equal to what, student? 4R. So this is 4R is equal to root 2 A. So we can write here as A is equal to 2 root 2 R. So A is equal to 2 root 2 R. This is the relationship between A and R. Now let us calculate the packing efficiency here. So the packing efficiency is equal to Z is number of atoms. In abscissa, Z is 4 multiplied by 4 by 3 pi R cube divided by A is 2 root 2 R cube multiplied by 100. On doing the calculation, it comes out to be 74%. Now question is, which one is best packing here? Best solid will be made up of abscissa having maximum packing efficiency of 74%. Then it will be BCC with 68% and finally simple cubic with 52.4%. So this is whole about packing efficiency or packing fraction.